Hi, and welcome to Curriculum Planning, Forensic Science. Meet Barb Fryer, who teaches forensic science in UKIPA. When Barb first started teaching her class, she was completely overwhelmed. After looking through standards, course outlines, and some old textbooks the previous teacher had used, not only was she uninspired, but she just didn't know where to start. Luckily, Barb had a mentor who set her on the right path to quality curriculum design. To get a bird's eye view of the forensic science course, Barb's mentor had her download a copy of the Forensic Science and Crime Scene Investigation outline from her district's website. By reading the document, Barb was able to see what students expected from the course based on the overview, some activities that they would expect to participate in, skills they would learn, and state standards that applied. She was feeling a little better about what she would need to teach and what wasn't actually part of her class. But it wasn't really enough to walk into her classroom and teach with, so Barb went back to her mentor for advice. Her mentor shared a curriculum planning technique called backwards design. She advised Barb to begin with the standards in mind, to ask herself what skills were her students supposed to have by the end of the course, and how would Barb know they had them? Barb's mentor said that once Barb had figured out how to assess her students' understanding, then she could design curriculum that specifically taught those skills. She would be teaching to her own test. Barb liked that idea and found that it made sense, and it seemed to fit well with the project-based learning model she planned to use to really connect her students with hands-on forensic science. But she still didn't know what to teach come Monday afternoon. Barb's mentor had another good idea. She helped Barb find Stu, another forensic science teacher at a neighboring high school. Stu was open to having Barb stop by and talk about how he organized his curriculum. Barb knew she would develop her own approach that worked for her own students, but it was super helpful to see the decisions that Stu had made. So then Barb sat down and started to figure out what she wanted to teach. She found a really interesting project on the CTE website that she knew her students would love, called The Body as a Crime Scene, STEM Integrated Project, written by Jay Crawford, Gordon Stanford, and Jody Halligan. But she wasn't sure when to teach it. Barb's mentor had another practical idea. She advised Barb to sit down with a large paper calendar or daily planner and a copy of her school's calendar. Then she said that Barb should write in all the holidays, modified days, assembly days, etc. Then Barb should add in what she knew were less than ideal instructional weeks. For instance, the first week of school has many adding and dropping students, so a big project would be harder to do as well. The last week before winter break, students are often absent and or find it hard to focus, so planning less critical and yet engaging active content for that week is a good idea too. Barb's school swaps its whole bell schedule during finals week, so Barb needed to keep that in mind, as well as school-wide testing days. Once Barb had all that information on her planner, she could easily see what days and hours she had left to work with. So Barb penciled in the big projects that she wanted to make sure happened, and then she wrote notes to herself about skills her students would need to complete those projects to be sure that other lessons were taught ahead, alongside, or that resources were made available. Barb liked how things were shaping up, but she still didn't have a plan for Monday afternoon when she met with her new students. Barb's mentor shared an aphorism: "Begin as you mean to continue." She went on to explain that Barb shouldn't wait to get to the exciting content about forensic science. She should jump right into it to engage her students immediately in how exciting and interesting the class was going to be for them. She advised Barb to create an opportunity for her students to share what they already knew about forensic science and maybe a little bit about their own personal experiences. It worked like a charm. On her first day, after sharing with her students a very intriguing crime scene, solved, of course, by forensic science, she had them share, in small groups, crime scenes that they had witnessed. While a few were raccoon-stealing trash mysteries, a couple had seen some car accidents, and one had even seen a murder scene in his neighborhood. They couldn't wait to learn more. Thanks for watching.